Start with the quieter first for my soul.
Hey, it's a punter.
Tell him we're closed.
We're closed.
That's only a small job, a little dent on the wing.
Sorry, can't help you.
It's a shame, because it got such a good reputation for paint jobs.
Are you winding me up?
No, but I am about to wind up my window.
Close it! Look! Rick, it's a law! Rick, it's a law! Rick!
Morning line.
No, I had to take my car to the garage.
I haven't got the car, that's what I was saying earlier about it anyway.
Oh, I see. I'm sorry, I thought you were offering me a lift.
I'm offering to walk you home.
I'm going in your direction anyway, so it's not a problem.
I do know what my direction is.
It's Jericho. All right?
Yes.
You tell me.
Did I?
Ages ago. Canal Reach number 9.
Ollie.
I hesitated about the number in case you think I've dwelt on it.
First name.
That's right.
So?
I don't use it.
Don't be silly.
My parents, who were silly.
What do your friends call you?
I don't know, Moss. It's interesting because 10 years ago, this street, or this area anyway, was not considered fashionable.
And now it's Oxford trendy, you think?
Oh, no, 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 I didn't mean...
No, I know what you meant. Can I give you a cup of tea?
Thank you. No, I mean... I meant, this is a very nice area.
Oh, shut up.
They're worthy of...
Anyway, tea would be great.
So you like my house, though. I must say, things like 10 years ago, this is the kind of furniture people liked.
Right.
I've got to say, this is the kind of house I really like.
And I have to tell you, this is the kind of house I really like.
Well, that's good. Oh, I think Ned's here. Ned? You here?
Sorry, am I interrupting something?
No, no, not at all. Ned is...
I'm just going.
Don't worry, I've just been very kindly brought home. Ned, this is...
Morse. Hello, Ned.
Ned uses the piano. He writes music.
Really? Not really. Anyway, listen, I should probably get along. Don't mind me. I'll go upstairs.
No, you don't need to do that. I'll put the kettle on.
What kind of music? Sorry? What kind of music do you write? Short music.
Very good music.
Anyway, my books are upstairs. There's no milk, by the way.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Come through. He's really talented, really. Doing a law degree, or rather not doing one. He's a marvellous musician. He's a terrible lawyer.
Should let a lot of people play your piano?
Every day. It's how I live. I teach.
Oh, right.
I don't teach Ned. He's, well, he's sort of adopted. He adopted me. There isn't any milk. Will you have something else?
No, no. Really, don't bother. It is a nice house.
Thank you.
It's exactly as I imagined it.
And this is very impressive. I've got one of these beauties.
Have you? Mm. I used to work for them, Richards.
Did you?
A long time ago. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been able to afford... It was a present. A going-away present.
I am going to go, I think, but, well, listen, I hope perhaps we could do something. Perhaps a film or something, if you're not too busy. But let me know.
That would be good.
Okay.
Okay. I'll see you next week, then.
Yes, look forward to that. Bye.
Bye.
Sorry, did I frighten him off?
Probably.
Well.
Well, what?
I can't stand men his age. The way they are with women. The way they pant over you.
What do you mean, pant? He's just a very nice man. He's in the choir. He was going to have a cup of tea. That's all. Before you pinched all my milk. I've got a pupil in a minute. I want to get changed. You could get some milk.
Okay. Money's a small problem.
There's some in my purse. I'll get it.
Very awesome, my man.
Beautiful. don't know how you can bear it, that noise.
Have some of this.
Thanks.
Are you getting anything done?
No.
Are you trying to get anything done?
I've written about 40 bars of my piece.
I meant your law. Good, terrific. I'm pleased about the piece.
I want you to hear it. Are you interested?
Yes, I want to hear it.
It's probably rubbish.
Ned, I want to talk to you about money.
I know, I must pay you back. I told you about the bank. It's ridiculous.
No, in fact, I don't want you to pay me. Have you taken any money from my purse for some reason recently?
No.
I'm only asking because if you were short of cash again, I could lend you some more. I'd rather do that than for you to feel you had to take it from me.
I said I haven't.
Right.
Do you want me to give you your keys back? I mean, I will. I'll give you them back.
No, I just wondered whether you were especially short of money at the moment.
Christ, I can't breathe in my rooms, and now I can't breathe here.
It's all right.
Sometimes maybe I may have picked up things without realising. I don't know if I have.
It's all right. You only have to ask me. Please, just ask me.
Real beer.
I'm sorry, I don't know the difference. Is that why we came here?
Partly.
Cheers.
Cheers, yes. Anne, I was wondering if we could go somewhere next week after the performance to celebrate. If you're not already...
No, I'm not doing anything. Although I expect people want to go somewhere as a group, don't you think?
Yeah, I expect so. It was just a thought.
Yes, of course. We could always go somewhere anyway.
Oh, well, good. You know... Ah, well, let's see. Could I run you home later? I've got a car tonight.
Come through. I'll get the kettle on. Sorry, it's a mess.
Oh, it looks fine.
I imagine your house to be very...
Very what?
I don't know. Very something.
Oh, yes, it is. Extremely something.
Are you really a policeman?
Yes.
I was sure... Do you take sugar? I had you down for, well, anything other than a policeman.
Hope it doesn't stand against me.
No. Why should it? Of course not. In what sense?
I don't know.
You enjoy it?
It's okay. What about piano teaching? Is that fun?
Yes. It's not fun. It's okay. It's fine. It's okay. Well, you have high hopes, don't you? And then one day you turn around, there you are, a piano teacher. It's fine. I like my house. I like my pupils. I'm fine.
And is there anybody important at the moment around?
I think so, yes.
Can't say fairer than that. No. What? No, I thought there must be.
Oh, this kettle takes an age. Would you just excuse me if I pop upstairs?
Point me at the teapot and I'll do the honours.
Oh, well, bless you. It's, well, you can see...
Anne, you all right?
I'm, yes, I'm fine. I'm just...
Look, I'll finish my tea and let you get off to bed.
Yes, that's probably it. I'm bushed. You're very thoughtful. I don't mean...
I don't mean that in a patronizing way. I just feel you're very sensitive.
No. I'm very disappointed. I couldn't believe there wouldn't be anyone, but... I had fantasized, I suppose. Even after last week and your friend, but... anyway.
It's not like that. It's too complicated to explain. It's all very stupid. It's a complete mess. I think the point is that it's the wrong... At another time, it's not you. I really like you.
Right.
Really?
I'll pick you up next week, drive you to the performance.
Really, it's so closed, I can...
Nevertheless.
Thank you. I'd like that. Good night.
Good night, Anne.
Talk. I must see you. Don't, please. Well, just come over. Well, anytime. I'm not going anywhere. I don't believe you. I don't know. Will you call me back? I'm coming. I have to go. Yes.
Yes. Oh, here's McKee. Morning. I've just come to see if the wall at the back's dried out so that I can make good.
Right.
I'm not disturbing you, am I?
I would prefer it, Mr. Jackson, if you didn't spy on me in the evenings.
What's that supposed to mean?
You know very well what I'm referring to.
I'm sure I don't.
I don't want any unpleasantness.
And I'm telling you, I don't spy on nobody. Spy?
Well, anyway, now I've said...
I think it's a bloody insult. I do.
Mr. Jackson...
That's all right, I'll finish the work. Unless you want to get somebody else.
No, please go ahead.
Anne!
What's going on? Is she all right?
I'm afraid not, sir, aren't we? Sir? We're trying to keep people out of here, sir. There's a hell of a crowd in there.
Who reported this?
Anonymous phone call.
Man or woman?
I'd have to check, sir.
Never mind. Have you touched anything out here?
No, sir. Have you spoken to Chief Inspector Bell?
Just passing, Sergeant. Just poking my nose in.
Shall I tell the Chief you're
was
here?
Was there a note?
No, sir.
Don't mind me.
Shut the door, Lewis. It's not a party.
Yeah. I was just passing. Came to see what all the fuss was about.
Lived alone. Piano teacher, apparently. Seen dozens like it time of year. Grim. Anyway, how are things at the circus?
I'll let you get on with it.
She managed to kick the stool halfway across the room.
What?
She kicked the stool away somehow. Lewis is full of grand theories.
I just don't understand.
Let's finish off here, for Christ's sake.
Anyway.
Sir, the key.
Oh, yes.
Good night, sir.
Morse. You know who he is, don't you?
Ah, no, I guess, sir.
Wandering around Jericho, eh? I'd often wonder what he did at night, besides the booze.
I've heard he's meant to be a very clever man.
Is he? I've heard he's after the superintendent's job, and I don't like that, Lewis. You know why?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Because somebody else we know is after it and all. Someone who is pig-sick of evenings like this. Hey?
Is there a fish and chip shop around here?
Not that I know of, sir.
Right.
Thank you. bit early. It's not a takeaway.
I've got money.
Yeah? Well, you owe me 15.
I've got lots of money.
Anyway, I haven't got anything. I haven't.
Shit.
Look, I'm cold and I haven't got anything.
I must have something now.
What's the matter with you?
What's the matter with you?
All right. Wait there. I'll have to go.
In town. Can you do that?
I don't know why you bother. She must know.
There's a difference between knowing and having to. I don't want her to have to cope with it, that's all. It's nothing, you know, it's nothing for me, but if Adele has to take it on, then it becomes... and it's nothing.
Yeah, I've got all that.
Well, then cover for me.
Excuse me, Mr. Richards. I have an urgent call for you.
Hello?
Police.
I'm sorry to bother you, sir. I was hoping you might be able to help me.
I didn't do it, honest.
I'm sorry?
It's a joke. I didn't do it. Joke.
I see. Did you by any chance cut that key?
I'd have done. Don't know. Cut lots of keys.
Perhaps if you had a good look at it.
If you're asking whether I ever cut keys for the woman in Canal Reach, then the answer's yes.
Uh-huh.
I presume that's what you're here about. It's a small place, mate. Yes, I always say this. Most of life finds its way through a hardware shop. You think about it. I mean, why should anyone want new keys? Another bottle of meths. Another dinner service. Huh? Just storing everything. Amazing. Yeah, I'll cut that.
So tell me, why would Anne Staveley want a new key cutting?
Being more interesting, why should she want four keys cutting?
Four?
Yeah. There's another story in that.
Okay.
Well, I'll tell you, one person has had a key off of her.
I'm all ears.
Oui.
Thank you, Mr. Grimes.
Mrs. Richards. Richards Audio Research. Could you hold the line, please?
Is he in?
Yes. Do you want to go straight
no,
in, or shall I?
Hello, what brings
you? I'm afraid he's engaged. Can you call back later?
Please don't. You're so transparent. Bye. Next page.
I haven't
got Anne Staveley is dead.
Are you serious?
I want you to tell me the truth. And listen, I heard the phone call this morning, so don't. I want you to tell me the truth. And then I will tell you the truth.
Yeah?
Mr. Jackson.
Don't give much thought to other people's peace around here, do you? Up and down with those radios crackling. Don't give much thought, do they, darling?
Did you know Miss Staveley?
Well, not the sense of knowing her, no. I mean, I knew her, but we didn't have nothing to do with each other.
Uh-huh. Do you mind if I sit down?
Suit yourself.
No, it was just I understand you might have been doing a few odd jobs for Miss Staveley.
Well, I do jobs for everyone around here. I mean, that's what I do, so I mean...
Of course. So, you've been working for Miss Staveley recently?
Yeah. Yeah, I did her new front door and some bibs and bobs and... I repointed her back wall. Just finished it. But I hardly said hello, let alone anything else. I just go in and do the job and come home.
I see. And did Miss Staveley give you a key or what?
Yeah, that's right, I had a key. I'll give it back, though. Yesterday afternoon, as a matter of fact, I slipped it through a letterbox.
Why? Wasn't she in?
Well, I rang the bell, but I didn't wait. She's a piano teacher. Do you know that? A whole load of people going in and out of that house, all sorts. Oh, well, I slipped it through a letterbox. It's all right now.
Why do you think Miss Staveley might have killed herself?
I don't know. I don't go poking my nose into other people's business.
Did you strike you as a happy woman?
Well, yes, I think so, yeah. Seemed all right. You know one of your blokes was round here yesterday afternoon, don't you?
What do you mean, one of our blokes?
Well, I swear I saw someone go into a house yesterday afternoon. I've seen him around there before. And he was there again last night. I swear it was the same bloke.
Was this a uniformed officer?
No, it was a bloke in a dickie and a bow tie. Senior-looking sort of bloke.
And you're sure of this?
Well, definite, yeah. He's been round here late at night, this bloke. Doing a spot of late-night investigating, I shouldn't wonder. It's quite the fashion at number 9, that sort of thing.
Excuse me, sir. You've still got a bit of
gun?
Yes, sir. You were explaining, sir, how you came to be revisiting the scene.
Not about explaining, I was telling you. Why? Do you have any doubt about my...
I do, sir, yes.
And are you going to pass on this doubt to Chief Inspector Bell?
I think so, sir.
Are you?
I'm also going to have to tell him, sir, that I've reason to believe that you were in the vicinity of the house on the day Anne Staveley died. And that it's not beyond the bounds of possibility that you were having an affair with Miss Staveley.
Oh, no, just
hang on. Who you knew through
us.
Your mutual membership of a choral society. You just hang on a minute, sir. I also think you might have had a key from Miss Staveley, and that you had some reason to suspect that she might have come to some harm, hence your sudden appearance when we met at Canal Reach. You might also have been borrowing money from Miss Staveley, again, for some reason which I can't, which I'm not too sure about.
Lewis, listen, tell me about this key I'm supposed to have. No. Tell me about this money I've been borrowing. No, in fact, tell me, as you've obviously been doing your homework, tell me everything you know about Anne Staveley.
You're not going to deny that you
Lewis,
knew
Lewis, actually, I think the best thing is for you to follow me back to my place. I've got a bottle of some very good Desert. We're clearly going to have to swap. Oh, I would actually like to get back to Canal Reach tonight. We could always get to an off-licence.
Apart from anything else, I think my wife wouldn't be too happy.
Fair enough. We'll get to an off-licence, OK? I'm probably going to have to ask you to lend me some cash, but...
Dear Mr. Richards, it's about Mrs. Staveley who died. I know all about her. Does Mrs. Richards. I know all about it. I hope you believe me, because if you don't, I'm going to tell her everything. You are rich, and what is £1,000? If you agree, I'll not bother to write again. The spelling is... Make sure the police don't know anything. Here's what to do. Don't give me anything traceable, so get the money and use notes. I hope you'll not try anything funny. Please remember your wife. Should I speak to Adele?
No.
Mrs. is spelled M-I-S-S-I-S.
You're not going in?
In a minute.
Waiting for me?
No, I'm having a decent cup of coffee. Oh, I hate this place. I hate inquests. Dreadful coughing, it's like a funeral without... I don't know. What's a good thing about funerals?
Nothing. Music?
So, what's this about you and the dead woman?
I want to try and get the inquest adjourned.
You're a bloody idiot, Tynesmoss. Why did you just say you were knocking her off?
Because I wasn't.
To save me a lot of aggravation, I've got better things to do than bugger around looking at diaries and address books. Anyway, just keep your mouth shut and let things go through this morning. It's a good job Lewis has got a bit of nouse. It would look great, wouldn't it? Especially with you after a superintendent's badge. Suicide woman carrying copper's child.
What?
Thank you. Could you please give me your name?
Harriet Louise Staveley. Harriet Louise Staveley.
What is your relation to the deceased?
Mother. I'm the mother.
I have to ask you if you formally identified the body of your daughter, Anne Jacqueline Rosemary Staveley.
I have. Yes.
Estimate the time of death at somewhere between 7 and 9:30 a.m. on the morning of the day of discovery. Apart from the contusions to the neck already described, the deceased had suffered fractures to the laryngeal cartilages and the cervical vertebrae were dislocated. Otherwise, all principal organs were sound. Weight at death was around 57 kilos. The deceased, who bore the marks of previous childbirth with both striae gravidarum and linea gravidarum, was again pregnant, and I estimate the fetal age is somewhere between 8 and 10 weeks.
Thank you, Doctor. Have you any doubt in your mind that this woman met her death by her own hand?
My job, sir, is to certify death where it has occurred and to ascertain, where possible, the physical causes.
Yes, and you've ascertained the death was caused by hanging. In your opinion, was the death self-inflicted?
In my opinion, I would say it was possible. Possible.
Thank you. You may stand up. I now call upon Chief Inspector Bell to give evidence. I have your statement before me, Chief Inspector. Can I ask you if you have any amendments or additions to make to it?
Not at present, sir, but the pathologist's information about Miss Staveley's pregnancy, which was only with us yesterday, does raise certain questions which I can't at the moment provide answers to. I wish to make a formal application for an adjournment until we can complete our inquiries.
I see. Do you have any objections to my issuing a burial notice?
No, sir, we have no objection.
Very well. This inquest is adjourned until July 3rd, when a jury will be present.
Thank you, sir.
All stand.
Have a drink later, Max.
Maybe. Dinner.
Mrs. Staveley, yes. Hello. My name is Morse. I'm a police officer. I was a friend of your daughter's.
And do you think Anne killed herself?
I don't know. I don't know what happened, but I don't think she killed herself.
But who would want to hurt her? She was such a kind girl. She was a kind girl, but if you knew her, you'd know that. She was always. She was so generous, and she...
Look, not now, but sometime. could we talk? I'll give you my telephone number.
Yes, yes.
Will you call me?
I will call you, yes. Thank you.
There is one thing I'd like to know that can't wait, and that is, did you know that Anna had been pregnant before?
Oh, yes, yes, but that was years ago. She married the father. That was years ago. I mean, that was what ruined her, the baby and then the marriage, and then it spoiled everything. She was 18.
Right, and what happened to the baby? I mean, do you... where does the child live?
Oh, I'm afraid I can't tell you that. The baby was it was a boy. The baby was adopted, and I never even saw him. And then you see, she gets pregnant again. She got pregnant again, and look what happened.
Was that a surprise? I'm pregnant again.
Until last night, I had no idea. No.
So you couldn't think who the father might be?
No, no. But if you were her friend, haven't you got any idea?
That's what everyone keeps asking.
I want Mr. Alan Richards. It's a personal matter. Just tell him it's a personal thing. Yeah, all right. Mr. Richards? Well, we don't know each other as such, but let's just say that I'm a friend of Anne Staveley's. Or should we say, was Mr. Richards? One. Yeah, yeah, I heard you. You got my letter. Well, how much then? Yeah, I can remember. I just wondered how much you're saying. Glad you've done this, Mr. Richards. And so will Mrs. Richards. Look, don't you threaten me, Mush. I could make things very black for you. Yeah, well, I could. So you remember that. Very black. Okay. This is what you do.
Ned about?
I'm afraid he isn't, no. Can I help?
No, it was Ned I was hoping to catch. I'm a relative. Uncle.
Really? Did I meet you at his birthday thing? I don't think I did.
No, that's right. No, I missed it.
Well, anyway, I'm sorry.
I'll wait. Do you mind?
Oh, really? It's just I've got a lecture. Have you come a long way?
Oh, quite, yes. Would you rather I waited from outside?
No. No. Come in.
Thanks.
That's Ned's bedroom, through there, and mine through there. We share this room. It's not very tidy, is it?
Sorry.
Oh, don't worry. Does he bring Anne back here much?
Anne?
Anne Staveley. He seems to be mentioning her a lot in his letters, that's all.
I don't know the name, sorry.
We were wondering whether he'd found himself a girlfriend.
No, I don't think so. But Ned doesn't bring his friends back. It's not a big place, and we don't... He spends a lot of time out, actually. We both do.
But he does have a lot of friends. This is Anne Staveley. Do you recognize her?
No. No, I thought it was his mother. This is our first term sharing, and as I said, we're different subjects and...
Who's the dance fan? Is that you?
No. Oh, this'll be him.
Ned.
What?
Your uncle.
What? I think uncle is a slight exaggeration, but we have met. Chief Inspector Morse.
Christ.
What? Ned, he said he was your uncle.
Did you kill Anne Stavely?
Get out.
Why didn't you come to the inquest? You know, I've had a lot of trouble finding you. Don't you go to classes anymore?
Look, I've got to go.
Well, that's fine. You go.
No, you go. You stay.
I can't work out whether or not you're having an affair with her. My guess, not. But you were certainly stealing from her.
No, I was not. Yeah, I've met you before. That's right, at Jericho. Yeah. Anne said you tried it on with her. I didn't kill her. These guys like you couldn't say two words without trying to shove a hand up her skirt.
That's what she said, is it, about me?
Everyone used her. She was sick of being used. Always someone's punch bag, that's what she said. I loved her. She was everything to me, a mother and a... Wasn't just 5 minutes tickle away from the wife.
I'm not married.
Look, can I... Is there anything I can do because I didn't...
I wasn't talking about you.
So it was your baby, was it?
What?
She was pregnant.
I don't believe you. That's complete crap.
Look, I've got to...
No, it's the truth.
I want you to go now.
I've still got some more questions. I want to know what you did with the money you stole from Anne Stavely's purse. Or was she so much of a mother to you that she gave you the odd £100 now and again?
I don't have to listen to this.
Don't! For God's sake!
instance, garlic.
Is there Dr. Mineral there? Thank you.
I'm sorry, the health centre's closed.
Well, look, the point is, I get a prescription and bring it for you. I didn't ask for this stuff, I'm ill. The guy writes out the script and I collect it, I'm ill. He clearly thinks it'll help me get better. I'm asking you, do you ring every doctor?
When you say you're ill, what exactly is the problem?
Actually, I have an addiction problem as it happens, not that it's any of your business, but since you obviously...
I'm sorry, I cannot dispense this prescription. You'll have to come back tomorrow morning when the health centre's open and I can ring Dr. Minero.
Thanks a shit. I mean, really, thanks a complete shit. Okay, well, can I have it back? Because I need it back. Thanks.
I'm sorry, you'll have to collect it in the morning.
You're a pleasant man, do you know that? A regular guy.
Heard of the sad news of Anne's tragic death. It so happens that she worked for Mr. Richards at one point, and it was at her suggestion we invited him along to talk to us this evening. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, on the fascinating subject of how a small Banbury engineering company made an international impact on the world of hi-fi, I am very happy to welcome a name familiar to all serious music enthusiasts. Mr. Alan Richards, Managing Director of Richards Audio Research. Alan.
Thank you. Yes, well, just to repeat Mr. Hornsby's remarks about my lateness, and for which I apologize, and also to share his sadness at the loss of Anne Staveley. She was a very dear personal friend, as well as someone who worked with me, so... There's not a lot one can say, really. It's a terrible thing. Except perhaps to take care, all of us, with those we care about. Well, Anne indeed suggested I come and talk to you this evening about the company that my brother and I founded some dozen years ago and with which Anne was closely involved in the early years. Now, I'm not really much of a talker, but I am something of an evangelist as far as this thing is concerned, the Richards turntable.
Who's there?
Good night, thank you.
Oh, you're the singing policeman.
Which travels before me, the singing bit or the policing bit?
No, I saw you at the inquest, Anne's inquest, and then the chairman pointed you out to me.
I enjoyed your talk.
Thank you.
Yeah, I've got a Richards deck.
Oh, I'm honoured, Chief Inspector.
How did Anne Staveley acquire hers?
That was a farewell present.
Such a generous firm, I'm surprised she left.
Morse, what's the excitement?
Incident in Jericho, sir. A man believed killed.
Whereabouts?
Canal Reach. We'll get in the number for you, sir.
Thank you.
just so happened to be in the area.
That's right.
And you knew him too, did you?
Jackson. No.
No. Well, somebody didn't like him very much. Split open his head.
I know the feeling.
What's the estimated time of death?
No, no, don't tell me. Between 7 and 8 this evening.
I don't know yet. Max is up there now. What makes you think you know?
Just a hunch.
I don't much like your involvement in this, Morse.
No.
But if you are, if you know something I don't, I want to hear about it.
Fair enough.
So?
I'll tell you what I know. A woman apparently commits suicide and no one knows why. We find out about it from an anonymous phone call. Then we find out that this single woman is pregnant. A fortnight later, a man living opposite gets his head mashed in. Interesting, eh? Mm.
More interesting than that. Somebody is kind enough to call us about Mr. Jackson's demise.
When? What time?
9:45, something like that.
Well, will someone have recorded the exact time?
Look here, Morse.
No, no, it's not the same caller. No. Now, Jackson called about Anne's death, I'm certain of that. I went to the box at the top of the road on the night she died. The directory was open on P. There was a strong smell of fish, Jackson's perfume. I tell you what I think, Bell. I think that Jackson saw something on the day Anne Staveley died, and somebody else didn't want him to tell us about it.
Then I hope it isn't you, Morse. Because you keep turning up like a bad penny.
I do, don't I?
What are you doing here?
I've already asked, Max.
Don't mind me.
Hello, Lewis.
Evening, sir. I'm sorry to hear about your head. How is it?
Sore.
Not as sore as Jackson's.
I'm going to find this Murdoch before he picks on anyone else.
You think?
Chief Inspector Morse is very keen to know the time of death.
I know thy morning.
You know now.
Nope.
A guess.
Between 9 and 9:30.
That's a guess.
The body is still warm.
Fitting with your theories, Morse.
It buggers them to hell.
Where were you between 9 and 9:30?
Oh, I have the perfect alibi. The problem is, so does my suspect. We were together.
I'm sorry to drop by unannounced. You're not ill, are you?
No.
Well, I wanted a word.
Oh, yeah, come in.
Having a bit of a lie-in, eh?
Can I get you a drink, or a coffee?
No. I wouldn't mind if you could let that record a bit.
Oh, yes. Sorry.
Thanks. Well, how's the head?
Leaking. I'll live.
I was sorry about that. Well,
Oh, yes, sit down.
Well, I've got some good and bad news for you, Morse. We're not going to give you the super's job.
Right.
You're a clever sod, but you don't say the right things to the right people, and you never will. It doesn't bother me, but it doesn't do you any good. You didn't want it anyway, did you?
No.
I mean, the point is, hey, you're unorthodox. I mean, look at you. It's not exactly... But anyway, fine. I mean, I like that. It doesn't bother me, but...
Was that the good or the bad news?
We're giving Bell the job. He's not exactly a brain merchant, but he does... Well, I mean, I don't have to tell you, he's...
He fills in the forms. He always says the right
thing. Anyway, shut your mouth a minute and listen, Morse. I want you to tell me about the Jericho killings. You've got shit all over you at the moment.
I don't know why.
Not quite. I want you to tell me what you know about it, and if I'm convinced you're not mixed up in it, you can take it over. That's if I'm convinced.
I don't have to convince you of anything.
Get your clothes on and I'll take you for a drink. At least you stop sulking when there's a beer glass in front of you.
How can you think I'm mixed up with a murder case?
I just want to know what's going on.
Which pub? Not that bloody awful hole you go to.
Wherever you like, Morse.
Just give me 5 minutes.
Yes, could I speak to Alan Richards, please? Oh, yes, my name's Chief Inspector Morse. Thank you. Hello? No, I just wondered if you'd heard about the murder in Jericho last night. What? A man was killed. His name was George Jackson. Did you know him? Well, you must know someone in Jericho, Mr. Richards. This man lived opposite Anne Staveley. No, I'm not accusing you of anything, Mr. Richards. That's right, yes, you do have a pretty good alibi. That's right. Yes, I can vouch for you, Mr. Richards. I just wondered what you were doing on June the 11th. But let me jog your memory. That was the day Anne Staveley died. Well, anything you say to me will be treated with respect, Mr. Richards, if it's within the law. I see. And what would the lady's name be?
Oh, sorry, sir.
I think I'm going to have to insist on a name, Mr. Richards. And an address. Hang on. I'm sorry, hang up. A pen and a bit of paper. Right, thank you, Mr. Richards. Hills as in Dales. Woodstock. 37? Right. Oh, yes, I understand. Do you have any idea why Anne Staveley would want to commit suicide? No, I didn't think you would. Of course.
Lewis?
You wanted to see me, sir?
Oh, right, yes. I expect you've heard your boss is getting promoted.
Yes, sir.
Good, eh?
Oh, yes, sir. Marvellous.
I'm a quite different kettle of fish, Lewis.
Richards reckons he spent the afternoon Anne Staveley died under a duvet with a Mrs. Jennifer Hills. Go and see her and try and work how he could be in Woodstock and Jericho at the same time.
Righto. I'll see you later, sir.
I'm coming with you, Lewis. You're dropping me off at the Radcliffe. They found Ned Murdoch for us.
Haven't they?
No thanks to you. Has to take an overdose before I can speak to him. Well, come on. And I want the fingerprint reports from Jackson's house. I like full reports, Lewis. I like everything written down.
Right.
Right. What about the business of the parking ticket? You followed that up?
What do you mean?
The parking ticket. Richard's car was parked in Jericho on the day Anne Staveley died.
You didn't tell me?
There was a parking ticket on the windscreen. You see, somebody's lying. What's the point? I can't work out who.
No, I'll tell you what's worse.
I don't believe anybody. Careful, Lewis.
sort of state is he in?
Not great. There's a strong possibility he'll lose his sight in one eye.
Really? I understood he came in on an overdose.
He did, but in the process, he obviously got very disturbed to try to blind himself.
I need to talk to him. Is that all right?
You'll have to come back, Inspector. He's going to be in the theatre in 10 minutes. He's already had his pre-med.
Well, 10 minutes will be enough for the time being.
I'm sorry, you'll have to come back.
That's very inconvenient.
Nevertheless, come back another time.
In here.
Oh, sorry, sir.
Why?
Well, just... Anyway, do you want a light on?
No.
Do you want cheering up?
No.
It was Richard's car. The fine was paid first thing the next day by A. Richards, 216 Oxford Avenue, Banbury. And I've typed it all out.
Good. That's good. Is that how you spell debited?
Yeah.
What about the woman in Woodstock?
She says he was with her.
All afternoon?
Yes, sir.
And she looked like the kind of woman that'd keep you occupied all afternoon?
I don't know.
You don't know. Anne Staveley was that kind of woman, Lewis.
Call Richards. Make me an appointment to see him in the morning.
Right.
Well, one thing is certainly true. When Jackson was getting his comeuppance, Murdoch was lying in the Radcliffe. And if he didn't kill Jackson and Alan Richards didn't kill Jackson, who the hell did?
Maybe Superintendent Bell was right. The murder was to do with Jackson.
Superintendent, Christ. Let's go and find a pub.
I need to get home, sir. It's my night with the kids.
Well, you just have to be a bit late.
Sorry, sir. Another time. Oh, sir, before you go, there's news from the forensic people. They did find something when they went back to number 10. Two prints, and they weren't Jackson's.
Chief Inspector Morse.
Good morning.
Mr. Richards is expecting you. Please go through. Will I get you a coffee?
No, thank you. No coffee, thanks. Nice place to work?
Yes, very.
Richards a good boss?
Terrific.
You're very loyal.
Inspector Morse did come in.
This is beautiful. Why did you lie to me, Richards?
I beg your pardon?
You tell me you didn't go to Jericho on the day Anne Staveley died.
Well, that's the truth.
So who did you lend your car to?
My car? Nobody. The Merc, you mean? That was probably parked outside.
While you were with your friend in Woodstock?
That's right. I don't use the Mercedes. It's too easily. I have a little Metro. It's more.
I must say you're extremely generous. Not only do you lend somebody a very expensive car, you also pay their parking fines for them. Why don't we stop buggering about and you tell me what really happened on the afternoon of June the 11th?
Right, there's no point, is there, if you know about the parking ticket? Oh, okay, I did go to see Anne. Look, the fact of the matter is, some time ago I had been very close with Anne. I was in love with her, I think. One stage I considered leaving my wife, but that didn't happen. And so inevitably it became rather difficult here at the office with Anne, and it seemed best that she leave and find something less, because I made it financially, that was some time ago. It seemed that she was fine. We saw each other a number of times. Anyway, she called me. She wanted me to look in. She'd had some work done on the house, and I agreed, and that afternoon I went to Canal Reach, but in fact there was no one in when I got there.
Although you did go in?
Oh, sure.
How did you get in?
The door was open. There was nothing new in that.
Then what?
Well, I mean, as I said, there was no one there. I called her name a number of times, but no one answered, so...
So?
I left.
But you went upstairs, didn't you?
Oh, well, I might have gone upstairs just to have a look around, you know, see if she was having a bath or whatever, but... I can't remember.
You can't remember? You haven't got the foggiest, have you? Because you were nowhere near Aunt Staveley's that afternoon. So who are you trying to protect?
Me. My husband's covering for me, Inspector.
Husband?
That's right. We sent the secretary home. You see, Alan was lying about the car and the ticket and going to Jericho. My husband's very good at lying, Inspector. Over the years, he's lied his way in and out of a whole host of beds. For once, he's lying on my behalf.
Really?
It was me that went to visit Anne Staveley. It was me that got the ticket, and I paid it.
And did you kill Anne Staveley?
I didn't have to. She was already dead.
I know, Lewis. It smells like a saloon. I'm just going to open the window.
Morning, sir.
You're one of those people who has breakfast, aren't you?
Oh, yes, sir. So, what's the programme today?
I don't know.
Right.
Morning. Anyway, my car will be ready at lunchtime. Can't think in these other cars.
Well, that's good then, isn't it?
It's all right. It's a car.
I've got something to add to the Jackson file.
Which is?
He deposited £250 in the post office on the afternoon he was killed.
Really?
In cash.
Well, is this significant? I thought he did odd jobs.
Well, I'll check, but I don't think it was money he got for a job.
Well, I don't see why not.
Well, that's because you're in a bad mood. Why don't we assume it was money he got to be paid off?
Okay.
And let's assume that it was Richards that paid him off, because Jackson had seen something going on in Jericho on the afternoon Anne Staveley died. The money was for Jackson to keep his mouth shut, but... signs were Jackson wasn't going to do that, so Richards bumped him off.
See? And this is despite the fact that his wife says she went to Jericho, not him. Another woman swears he was in her bed at the time, and I swear he was giving a lecture when Jackson was killed.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, I think you're probably right, Lewis. At least that's the way it ought to happen, but this doesn't get us anywhere.
Well, I've been asking myself if someone else could have killed Jackson for Richards. And if so, who? His wife? His brother.
Very sparky this morning.
Oh, you can't beat a cooked breakfast. And it's also my birthday. That might be something to do with it.
Go and see the brother, then. Ask him if he killed Jackson. And take his fingerprints. And the other ones, too, while you're about it. And the wife's. And find out if Jackson's recently been paid for a job, because if he has, your theory's all to cock. I mean, Dan Staveley could have taken that £100 out to pay Jackson for some job he did for her. In fact, that could be part of the 250.
No, it isn't. Anne Staveley paid him by cheque. I've got her cheque stub and his paying counterfoil.
Yeah, it's all right, Lewis. No need to go mad. Come on, then. We'll celebrate your birthday.
Oh, no, thanks, it's a bit early for me.
Suit yourself.
His parents are driving down this evening. I've no idea what I'm going to say to them.
Why should they expect you to say anything?
Well, I'm his tutor. I mean, I had no idea about the drugs business. And now this. I gather that the family, his family, are childless. That's the other thing.
Really?
Apparently, yes. There's cystic fibrosis on the mother's side. I don't quite know why, but she told me when I telephoned her, Edwin was adopted.
I didn't know.
No.
I want to send one of my sergeants round later to look through his belongings.
Unless you have any objection.
Well,
It's just routine. No, we're not intending to prosecute, despite the fact that he assaulted a police officer. Worse, he assaulted this police officer. Now, he's punished himself, so there's no point.
Well, that's very... Well, thank you. Well, in that case, of course, we shouldn't object to...
What an idiot. It's been staring me in the face.
I'm sorry, but what has?
Who killed Anne Staveley? It's been staring me in the face.
Trying to find whatever it was they were looking for when they killed Jackson.
Problem is, it couldn't have been Tony Richards because he was with me.
Certainly wasn't his brother. I didn't get that good a look at the man, but I'll swear it wasn't Alan Richards.
I know it wasn't. Alan Richards is in London on some conference or other.
Is he now? Should have bloody well asked.
Anyway, he can't be a suspect any longer.
Did you get Tony's prints?
Oh, yeah. I liked him, actually. I don't think he'd kill anybody. I did like him.
Speaks very highly of you, Lewis. What about Adele Richards? Is she in London too?
No, she's in Banbury still. Very happy to give her statement and her fingerprints. Very repentant. Oh, she also spent the evening Jackson died with Tony, she says. So that's his alibi.
Convenient. Very close family, aren't they? Yeah. And she's still saying she went to the house and burned the love letters her husband wrote to Anne Staveley.
And that she paid the parking ticket. She did as well.
You see the checks, Dad?
Yeah. So I was wrong about Richards, then. He didn't kill either of them.
Oh, no, he didn't kill Anne Staveley. No, no, Richards didn't kill her, but I'll tell you who did. Do you want to know?
Are you taking the piss?
No, no, I'm not. The man who killed Anne Staveley is called Sophocles.
Where was he when he's at home?
Look, I want you to do a couple of things for me, then I'll explain everything. I want to know the name of the other driver when Anne Staveley's husband was killed, and then I want to know what happened to the son she had adopted. Social services will tell you. And if they get Stroppy and Awkward, get Berry, Stroppy and Awkward back.
Do I know this, Sophocles?
Only if you loved your mother, Lewis.
Excuse me, sir. It's Arge. You said to let you know about those prints. Tony Richards and his brother's wife.
Adele Richards?
Yeah, that's right.
And?
Neither of them match with the ones we got from in here.
Still, at least we can make one arrest.
Who's that?
This is Sophocles, chap.
Lewis, Sophocles died 2,500 years ago.
What are you doing? You're just ragging me, or what?
No.
You are, aren't you? Look, OK, I don't know who this bloke is. Am I supposed to? At least I can survive half hour's work without reaching for a beer glass.
That's a good idea, Lewis. We still haven't celebrated your birthday. Come on. And I'll tell you why I'm deadly serious about Sophocles. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
And the same price, 5-1 Mighty Falls. I'd have some now, palladium now brought back last. Is Denny Lett the leader still?
No, actually, it was your birthday set me off.
Or partly.
You see, no, first things first. You know all about the Oedipus complex, Lewis, where you want to bed your mum and bury your dad, yeah?
Oh, I know the gist.
Oh, the gist will do fine. Sophocles wrote a play about it. Oedipus the King. Now, Oedipus was this big tyrant, this big man, who found out that the woman he'd married was his mother, and a man he'd killed in an argument at a crossroads was his father. So Jocasta, who was his wife and his mum, when she found out, guess what she did?
Killed him.
No. She hangs herself.
Oh, I see.
Interesting, eh?
I can't imagine marrying my mother.
Well, Oedipus wasn't too happy about it either.
Wasn't she a bit old for him?
She was very attractive. No. After she's hanged herself, he poked his own eyes out. Any of this sound familiar?
Yeah, yeah. Anne Staveley, innit? And she had a son who she had adopted.
Right. And guess who I find out today is an adopted son?
Edwin Murdoch.
Yes. And guess whose birthday falls on the same day Anne Staveley died?
Edwin Murdoch. It's just coincidence.
Anne Staveley had a copy of the Sophocles by her bed.
She'd almost certainly at one time or another had Ned Murdoch in her bed. Now, I know it sounds incredible, but maybe that's the point. I mean, why else should an intelligent, attractive woman suddenly decide to do something so terrible? I mean, why else does a talented young man blind himself?
Yeah, but what about killing the father? Where does that go? I go and find out who else was involved in the car crash.
Right.
Bloody hell.
Right.
Oh, that's impossible.
No. The only coincidence, really, is that Anne Staver's adopted son should turn up in Oxford. It's quite possible they should find themselves attracted to each other. The rest, after they found out, well, that's the product of something else. That's some kind of bizarre kind of atonement. No. I know.
Bloody hell. So Sophocles did it. Bloody hell.
Afraid there's nothing to report yet, sir.
Son, there's no point in haggling with social services. Go direct to the Murdoch boy. He's easy enough to find.
Yes, I've tried that, but he's being operated on again today. They're trying to rescue the... Well, he's got a retina damaged. Anyways, I said I can go back tomorrow, but in the meantime...
In the meantime, you and I are going to the Richards office. And you better make all your appointments early tomorrow. We're all meeting at Canal Reach for lunch.
Sorry, sir. Who's we?
Oh, everybody. And I'll tell you something else for nothing. If I'm right, or we were wrong, and Anne did commit suicide, there's a note somewhere. I want to read it. Oh, good man.
Can I help you?
Chief Inspector Moore, CID. I'd like to speak to Tony Richards.
I'm afraid Mr. Richards is at lunch. Can I take a message?
No, I don't think so. When you expect him?
I'm sorry, he may not be back again today, sir. He wasn't sure.
Yes, it's always a dilemma, isn't it? Coming back after lunch. We'd like to look around the offices.
I think one of the partners would prefer to show you rather than...
I haven't got time to muck about. You take Tony's office, I'll ransack Allen's.
Mrs. Richards, sorry to bother you, it's Jill. The police here without a search warrant. Yes, can you come over here as soon as possible? Okay, thank you, bye.
Oh, there's nothing in there, sir. What have you found?
Listen to this, Lewis. Brilliant. Amazing sound.
Where was it?
It was filed under B for blackmail. I'm serious.
So, Jackson was blackmailing him.
It looks like it. Except.
Except?
I'm not sure, but I can't believe Jackson wrote that letter.
Why do you say that?
I don't know. It's too... Dear Mr. Richards, it's about Mrs. Staveley who died. I know all about her, but does Mrs. Richards? No.
Well, we know he wasn't very clever. There wasn't a single book in his house.
Well, that's the point. Whoever wrote that wants you to think he's not very clever. But that letter... There's nothing to misunderstand. Despite the spelling, despite the punctuation, it doesn't affect what's being said. It's as clear as crystal. No, Jackson didn't write that letter. And if he didn't, Lewis, who the hell did write it?
I hope you've got a very good explanation for entering these offices without a warrant.
I have. I'm just photocopying it. I'll have to keep the original, but this is for your reference.
He knows something, doesn't he?
No, I think it's a complete bluff. He's trying to force us into some sort of confession. All he's got is that blackmail letter, and that's easily dealt with.
You reckon?
I can't stand this place. It gives me the willies. Look at it. As if a coat of paint on that door would do any good.
Oh, don't go maudlin on us.
Right. I've told
Eisen covered up and been humiliated on your behalf, but yes, I'll try not to go maudlin.
Here it comes.
Sorry I'm late. Still, nice day, eh? Tony Richards? We haven't met. I'm Morse. I thought you'd let yourselves in.
Shall we go into the front room? That's probably best. What do you think, Alan?
Sure, yes.
Might as well sit down, eh?
Anybody play?
Wonder what'll happen to these things.
Look, there's your lovely turntable gathering dust.
Tragic.
God, these fingerprint boys make a mess. Anyway, I asked you all to come here today because I was hoping Sergeant Lewis would be here by now. Anyway, can't be helped. Yes, yes, this was Anne Staveley's house, and in there is where she died. From that beam. She tied a cord to that hook. I expect it was normally used for hanging up her washing. Shut the door, and you can't even tell she's there. That's what happened to me. I came here on the day she died, and I didn't even know she was hanging there. That was while you were here, Mrs. Richards.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes, you were upstairs going through Anne's things, looking for any letters that might incriminate your husband. Much as yesterday afternoon I was going through your husband's office, looking for any letters that might incriminate him. You found love letters. I found a blackmail note. What did you do about that blackmail note, Alan?
I paid up.
Did you?
Yes, I gave Jackson the money.
When?
You know all this. Okay, on the day he died, I delivered the money. I had to leave it behind a telephone box just down the road.
There's no mention of this arrangement in the letter.
No, he called me shortly after.
I see.
Fine. So, you paid him the money. How much, by the way?
£250. I told him that was all I was prepared to give.
So, you paid him the £250, and later that day, he was murdered.
Well, you know it couldn't have been me. I was with you.
It wasn't your brother, was it?
Not even a brother would be prepared to go that far.
Oh, I don't know. I can't remember where you were on that particular night, Tony.
I was with Adele.
Oh, yes, yes, with your brother's wife. And you can vouch for that, Mrs. Richards.
Yes.
Yes. Well, I must say, I don't believe you. I think you killed George Jackson while your brother was giving his talk to our group. I think you followed Jackson back from the drop and confronted him in his house about what evidence, if any, he had about your brother's liaison with Anne Staveley. And when Jackson wouldn't play ball, you smashed his head open on his bedpost. How am I doing?
Well, it's rubbish, and you know it. Your sergeant took my brother's fingerprints, and they didn't match with the ones shown in Jackson's house. So what other evidence have you got?
And besides, if I'm prepared to cover up for my husband, why should he worry about being blackmailed in the first place? It doesn't make sense.
Well, I was hoping that you'd explain that to me.
I can't explain it because it didn't happen.
Tony didn't kill Jackson.
That'll be Sergeant Lewis. Will you excuse me? Thank God you're here. I'm halfway up my own backside.
Sorry, sir. I've been chasing all that stuff on the Anne Staveley adoption and whatnot.
Later.
No, I think you should know this now. Anne Staveley's son was adopted by a family in Wales. I've spoken to him on the phone this morning. He's a postman.
Brilliant.
Her husband was killed in a head-on collision just outside Portsmouth. The other driver was a pensioner, died instantly.
Naturally.
And I've also checked with Swansea. Edwin Murdoch doesn't even have a driving licence. Sophocles didn't do it.
Well, it looks as though I should send everybody home, as I'm clearly so far off beam.
Well, I hope that means you're going to leave us in peace from now on.
I don't think you can afford to be so righteous, Mrs. Richards.
Anyway.
Don't let us keep you.
Mr. Richards, we haven't met. I'm Sergeant Lewis.
Oh, hello.
What did you say?
I was just introducing myself to Mr. Richards.
Just say that again. Just repeat exactly what you just said.
We haven't met. I'm Sergeant Lewis.
You have met Lewis. You've taken this man's fingerprints.
No, so that's the Mr. Richards whose prints I took. Tony Richards.
Is this true?
I'm afraid, sir.
So which of you is Alan Richards?
Alan, don't try saying it too late!
Yes.
I want to try and close the Jericho case this evening. There's a few things I need to know just for my peace of mind.
All right.
Did you see Anne on the day she died?
Yes. Or rather, I saw her dead the day she died. I went round to the house in the morning and she was...
Right. And was there anything... Did you take anything from the room, or...?
Yes, I took money from her purse. It was money. You're not going to believe this. It was money she'd taken out of the bank for me.
I believe you.
She thought she was paying for driving lessons. I can't even remember. Some story I invented to get cash from her.
All right, but no letters, so... You didn't disturb anything else?
No, I panicked. I was so desperate for heroin, I couldn't even... I should have phoned the police and saved her the humiliation from hanging there all day. I was so desperate.
Were you the father of her child?
I don't think that's possible, Inspector.
Oh.
I don't have relationships with women.
I see. Right, okay. But there's just one more thing. A letter has come into my possession, addressed to a Mr. Alan Richards, and asking him for money. In fact, demanding money. I'm assuming that that letter was a sort of practical joke. Am I right in thinking that?
Yes.
Then you'd better have it back.
How did you know I sent it?
One of those guesses where you've guessed everything else and been wrong. And you typed the envelope and I checked it with your typewriter. And anyway, it had to be you because there wasn't anyone else, really. So, just genius.
Richard's hurt Anne so much. That's why she killed herself. She was tired of being hurt by man. Had no qualms about trying to get money off him. He had plenty. And he was so cruel to Anne. She said once that she waited every day for him to call or arrive, and he didn't bother.
I'll let that be an end to it. Burn it.
I will. Thanks. I miss Anne. Inspector?
I'm still here. Yes, I miss her too. Did she ever say anything about me? I know she talked about me at the beginning when I was a bit clumsy about asking her out, but did she say anything after that?
I'm sorry. Not that I remember.
No. I just wondered.
Oh, sir! Some good news, they found the letter.
What letter?
Anne Staveley's. It was inside one of Jackson's rods. The hollow, it seems, the rods.
One letter.
Just said a letter, I don't know.
Don't see why they couldn't have found it the first time, Rob. What were they doing?
We couldn't find it.
Come on, hurry.
No need to hold it up like a trophy. We all know what a fishing rod looks like. Who found it?
One of the boys, sir.
Well, I guess that.
Well, I think what happened is that one of the blokes is a bit of a keen fisherman and he was admiring the rods when he came across the letter.
What are you trying to say, Lewis? Where did this admiration of the rod take place?
In the chap's garage, sir.
In the chap's garage. Taking his work home with him, was he?
I've spoken to the man, sir. I'm pretty confident it won't happen again. And the fact of the matter is he could have just thrown the letter away, so...
Is the rest of Jackson's tackle in the shed?
Absolutely, yeah. Definitely.
All right, well, we'll all stay here till we find out whether or not there are any more letters.
Sir. Doesn't say what you thought it would say.
It says that Richards broke her heart. Take a copy of it. Let Richard see it. Forget it. There won't be any others.
I think he thought she might have written a letter to somebody else. And he read this and changed his mind. Oh, don't just stand there. Get this place tidied up. And this time, leave the rods alone. You're a lucky lad, Dixon. On another day, you'd have ended up with one of them fish hooks up your backside.
Amazing. Four of us went into that house on the day she died. First Jackson, then Ned Murdoch, and Adele Richards, and then me. And I'm the only one that came away empty-handed. Fancy a pint?
Ah, oh, I'd like to,
yes,
but...
Yes, yes, I know.
I'll see you tomorrow.